In this GIMP workshop, we will change a color photo into a vintage pin-up illustration with the standard filters and options in GIMP. If you want to follow along, you can find the download link for the image in the video description. When you use another image, you might want to adjust some of the steps given in this tutorial. When we've opened our image, we will start by adding an alpha channel. Right-click on the layer and hit Add Alpha Channel. Now we click on the white background color of the foreground background color button to open the color selection dialog. Type in the HTML notation F37200. Hit Enter on your keyboard to make the color visible in the current old section. Then click OK so our background color is changed, but the foreground color is still black. Press Ctrl+Shift+N to make a new layer. Name it Background. Select the layer fill type background color and click OK. Press Ctrl+Shift+N again to make another new layer. Name this one Vignette. And check the layer fill type foreground color. Go ahead and click OK. Now press the E key on your keyboard to make the ellipse select tool active. Then we make an oval selection like shown in the video. Hit Enter or click in one of the corners to apply. Go to Select in the menu bar and click Feather. Feather the selection by 300 pixels and click OK. Then hit the Delete key to remove the center area. Press Ctrl+Shift+A to deselect the selection. We make the mode of this layer Grain Merge. Click and drag the bottom layer to the top of the layer stack. We're going to remove the background. Selecting the background can be done in several ways depending on the characteristics of our photo. For this image I've used the Fuzzy Select tool. Press the U key to activate the Fuzzy Select tool. Make the threshold 30 and click somewhere in the background to select it. Now we go to Select and click Feather again. We're going to feather the selection by 10 pixels and then hit OK. Now we go back to Select and we click the option Grow. We grow the selection by 3 pixels and click OK. Hit the Delete key on your keyboard to remove the background. Press Ctrl+Shift+A to remove the selection lines. Then we press the S key to make the Smudge tool active. Zoom in by pressing the Ctrl key and rolling the mouse wheel away from you. With the bracket keys we can make our brush smaller or bigger. Now we're going to smudge the hair. Make sure to follow the direction of the hair lines. When we press and hold the spacebar, the smudge tool changes into the Move tool and we can move the image. When we let go of the spacebar, we have the smudge tool again. And when we make a mistake, we press Ctrl+Z to undo this. When the hair is done, we smudge the eyebrows. Then we go to the mouth and make some corrections. Then press Ctrl+Shift+J to fit the image in the window. Click on the duplicate icon at the bottom of the layers panel to make a duplicate of this layer. Go to the menu bar and click Filters, Blur and then Selective Gaussian Blur. Move the dialog box to the top of your screen and pull out the window. Then make the image good visible in the preview pane. Change the blur radius to 25. Click the preview off and on to see the difference. and click OK. Go to the mode and change it to Overlay. Then we make a duplicate of this layer too by clicking the Duplicate button again. Now we go to Filters, Edge Detect, and here we click Neon. Enlarge the dialog box again and make the preview good visible. Move the amount slider to its maximum and click OK. Then we go to colors and hit invert. We make the mode of this layer multiply. Click filters again, blur, and now Gaussian blur. Here we just click OK. Back to the menu bar and now to colors and curves. We can experiment with these settings. I've made the darker areas a bit lighter and gave the lighter areas a bit more to make the effect a bit stronger. Click the preview off and on to see the difference. When it's to our liking, we click OK. Now we open the color palette by clicking on the foreground colors. At the HTML notation, we fill in 2, 7, B, 5, F, F, hit Enter, and then click OK. Press the P key on your keyboard to make the paintbrush active. Change the opacity to around 40, and choose Brush Hardness 25. Now we zoom into the eyes, and click several times in both eyes to give them a nice blue color as shown in the video. Then press Ctrl-Shift-J to fit the image in the window again. To finish off, we will add a soft grain texture. Press Ctrl-Shift-N to make a new layer. Name it Grain. And check White as the layer fill type. Then click OK. Click Filters, Noise, and RGB Noise. Check the colorated noise and uncheck the independent RGB. Make the RGB 25 by clicking the arrowhead of one of the colors. Now click OK. Go to Filters again and click Blur and Gaussian Blur. Just click OK to soften our grain texture. Then we change the mode to Multiply. And there we have it, a nice vintage pinup portrait. I hope you have fun with this tutorial, and if that's the case, please give it a thumbs up, subscribe, and leave a nice comment to support my channel. Thank you very much for watching.